करो, सिस्टम प्रेफरेंसेस, डिस्प्लेज, अरेंजमेंट, मेरा डिस्प्ले।
वेल यू हैव सीन एवरीथिंग, यू हैव सीन हाउ द देर आर डायलिसिस ऑफ द कैप्सूल एंड वॉट हैज टू बी डन इज दैट वी हैव टू सी वेज ऑफ सर्वाइवल इन दिस सिचुएशन. द थ्रोन हैज टू बी देयर. वेल द सिचुएशन इज वी कम अक्रॉस डिफिकल्ट सिचुएशंस एंड दीज डिफिकल्ट सिचुएशंस हैव टू बी एडिक्वेटली टेकन केयर ऑफ इन दिस बैटल ऑफ द थ्रोन्स. हियर वी गो नाउ in the patient who comes across to us who has one eye only and he has a pre-existing posterior capsular defect in a posterior polar cataract. Rexes, what is a rexes? An oval rexes for that matter. You have to create layers because you have to create a situation where the posterior capsule is taken care of. So multiple layering is the answer because the patient is one-eyed and you want to save everything and put the lens where it needs to be put. Multiple layering, and after that take out the different layers keeping the cushion of epinucleus behind. See how carefully one has to go ahead and take care of this situation. Layer by layer, leaving a cushion behind is the answer to this situation. You can see the CD is zero, it's all phaco aspiration, nothing else. Now comes the situation wherein you have to take out the epinucleus. Since the epinucleus was big, I did not go in for a bimanual or a dry aspiration. Taken care of, the capsule is there. Now we have to see how we have to put the lens. Capsulorhexis, posterior capsulorhexis is the answer, and try to go through the side port, not the main port, because you have to have a stable anterior chamber. This stable anterior chamber is going to help because you'll be able to complete a posterior capsulorhexis. Posterior capsulorhexis is large. You have to see whether there is vitreous in the AC or not, which was not there. In comes the rescue of an oval rexis, and you can use the short arm to take care of that. Now we move on to the next situation wherein we have with us a situation wherein we see another patient who has, the video is not, yeah. Suhas, yes, this is another patient wherein there is another posterior capsule rupture in a PPC. Align the rexes in such a way that you are not parallel. The incision should also not be parallel to the posterior capsule rupture. Oval rexes is the answer. Here again, you have to save the situation, and the situation has to be saved. So this oval rexes done, which is a 2-in-1 rexes, modified technique, the modified technique of where you do not want to rotate the nucleus. You do not want to do any hydrodissection. You do not want to do any hydrodelineation. After sculpting, separate the into two, right from the proximal to the distal, totally separate it. Now what next? Because you don't want to rotate. Cross chopping is the answer. You will find this wherein the nucleus pieces adjacent to the 6 o'clock one is taken care of and is adequately managed without manipulating, without rotation. Just by realignment, the nucleus pieces are taken out. Mind it, the posterior capsule is ruptured, nucleus sclerosis is there, you don't want to do any hydrodissection, any hydrodelineation for that matter. Deepen the AC so that you don't. Here also there's a strong epinuclear mass. So that done, now comes the situation where you can do a dry aspiration. The dry aspiration is done, and you will see that you have been able to take out in spite of the fact that the posterior capsule was ruptured. Again, an oval rexis to your rescue, and the job is done. You have saved two patients wherein the capsule was already ruptured. Job done, and job done all the way. Thank you very much.